Since this tutorial went online back in October 2006, I keep receiving a lot of messages, a lot of people telling me that they couldn't follow, they couldn't understand how things work. So I decided to create this video tutorial. Hopefully you guys will be able to follow. Hopefully it would answer a lot of your questions. Okay, let's scroll down and let's go to step one. Okay, the first step is step 1.1. You need to switch to Evlak theme. In order to do that, you just go to the upper right corner of your site, of your multiply site, and you click on my account. Okay, then you click on my site. Okay, now the purpose of doing this, it will give us access to the customization site option. Or site customization option, sorry, in which they have the two important links for our tutorial. One is called choose the theme, the other one is custom CSS. The other way to gain access to the site customization is you go to below your profile picture and you click on customize my site, and voila, you have the site customization option. Now in step 1.1, you just click on choose the theme. That will lead us to a collection of themes that is provided by Multiply.com. Okay, I would like to call them base themes because it would add less confusion later in later tutorials. There it is. You just click on Evlak, right? Once you click on it, your Multiply site will transform to this green Evlak theme, right? With the green background, with a green banner on top, black menu, and white background, right? So the idea is to take this green area and customizing it the same manner that we customize a car, okay? But and the first step in customizing any car is we need to select the car itself. Okay, so I would like to call this a base car, the car that just came out from the factory. By selecting Evlak, we selected the car. From there, we customize it to become a customized theme. The first step in customizing a theme is step 1.2. If you have Photoshop, you go to File, create a new project. Let's just call it top, okay, with a width of 780 pixels or dots and the height of 222 pixels. Make sure they are in colors and just click OK. So basically this will create a working area in which you use your creativity to create something simple. Okay, right, I like to use Photoshop because Photoshop has this ability to create wonderful effect, wonderful pictures. Now after we finish the project, just click File, we save it. Okay, now okay, save as. Okay, let's save it somewhere let's save it in the desktop. This way we can easily find it, and we just call the let's call it top. But the most importantly, you have to change the format from Photoshop to JPEG. Okay, you see, JPEG is an excellent format for real life pictures, for high quality pictures. But if your project is very simple with a cartoon like picture, it's better to save it under GIF because GIF will take less amount of memory. Anyway, you just click on JPEG and you save it. All right. So another window will ask you whether to create a large file or small file. Basically, the larger the file, the higher the quality. The smaller the file, the lower the quality. We just put it in medium, somewhere in the middle, and okay, just save it. Right. So the end result is you will have a file called top on your desktop. Now, in step 1.5, we need to create another picture, another project. Just click on File New. This time, make it the height of 40. Okay, this will be our menu, right? And You probably wouldn't see it now, but just when you finish drawing in it, just save it as just follow the same similar steps as before. Make sure you save it in the desktop. Make sure you save it in the desktop, and let's give a file name of menu, menu. And last thing, make sure the format is in JPEG format. Okay. Now then save. Alright. So similar step. So now we have another file on your desktop, which is called menu. Now, if you don't have Photoshop, the other option is to use Microsoft Paint. Okay. In order to open Microsoft Paint, you need to go to the Start button, click All Programs, then Accessories. Accessories. Then you look for a program called Paint. Okay. All right. Then you have to set the project. You have to set the size of the project accordingly. You click on image menu, then attributes, then you set the width of 780 and the height of 222. Make sure it is in pixels and colors before you click OK. Now you start drawing. Alright, if I had a choice between Microsoft Paint and Photoshop, of course I would choose Photoshop, because Photoshop has this ability to create wonderful effect far more superior than the Microsoft Paint. Okay. However, if you don't have Photoshop, Microsoft Paint is available in most in all Windows platform. Now we are almost up. Let's put a picture here. Okay, this is a picture of me and IB. And just paste it here, and that's it. This is the end. Now I'm going to save it. Save as. Similarly, I want to put it in the desktop, because you know, just for me to find it easily later. Then I would call it top. Right. Then the type. Then make sure the format is, or the type of the file is in JPEG before I save it. All right. Now I would repeat this with similar step. I will create another file called menu. Alright. Just go to image, attributes, 780, and with height of 40 only. Make sure it's in pixel and colors. Then OK. Now this is the new workspace. Let's make it something simple. Alright. I'm going to use only two colors here, black and blue. This is a good example in saving a file in under GIF, because it will take a small size of memory. But for this example, I'm going to save the file name under menu. I'm going to just put it JPEG and save. Alright, now by right you will have two files on your desktop. One is called top and the other one is called menu. Alright.